Morgwaeth and a Blade-coven have been dispatched to the Beast Grave to search for a long-hidden shard of their deity, Cain, the god of murder. In this video, we're going to show how to paint the Hag Queen Morgwaeth. We'll also be picking out some details on a Melusai Kira as well. However, by following this guide, you can easily paint the remaining members of the Blood-coven warband. So once you're ready, grab those brushes, shake those paints, and let's get started. Before we begin painting, the first thing we'll need to do is undercoat the model. As you can see here, Morgwaeth has been undercoated with Korax White, which is perfect for all the colours we're going to be applying in this video. Now, the first area we're going to concentrate on is the skin or flesh. Now, for this, we'll be using Gulliman flesh thinned down with contrast medium. It's one part Gulliman flesh and one part contrast medium. So we're going to start with that. I'm using a medium layer brush for this, just for a bit more accuracy. And I apply the contrast medium first because I don't want to taint the pot. So I'm just going to add a little dollop like so, and then get some contrast in there as well, Gulliman flesh, and mix that in. Now it's slightly thinned down, so all I'm going to then do is mix that together like you can see here, and then just load the brush up. Now the key thing here is just to give the brush a couple of twists, just to maintain a nice point to it once we've done that, because there is quite a fair bit of contrast medium and contrast paint inside that bristle, so it will start to lose its point. So all I'm going to do is then just slowly pick out any skin details like that. Now try and avoid getting on the other areas. If you do, you can always tidy up at a later point. Once this is dry, just apply a second coat, but just keeping it more to the darker, deeper recesses of the skin. There we are with that second coat of Gulliman flesh now applied into those deeper recesses. What we're going to do now is move on to our next step of colours for the skin. So we're going to start with Korax White. This is going to be a layer on the raised details. After that, we're going to use thin down Gulliman flesh again just to change the tone of that Korax White. And then we'll finish off with a final highlight on the extremities of using a pallid witch flesh. But first of all, let's start with that Korax White. So what I'm going to do is just get a dollop or two, a little bit of water, a little bit more paint on there as well. That's better. And again, key as always is just make sure you get a nice pointy brush. I'm just using a small layer brush for this because it gives me a nice point. There's obviously some small detail too. Once we're happy with that, we're then ready to start picking out those raised details. So we're kind of treating it like a layer, like I said. So all I'm going to do is just start picking out things like on the face, like the nose and stuff, the cheeks, some of the details on the legs. With the Korax White now layered up, what we're going to do now is just use Gulliman flesh thinned down with contrast medium. Very similar to how we did when we first started. And all we're doing here is just knocking back some of that Korax White so it's not as stark. Just gives you a bit more mid-tone and dark shade in there as well. There we are with that thinned down contrast now applied and dry. We're just going to finish off by using pallid witch flesh as like a final highlight on the extremities. So things like nose, cheeks, knuckles, those kind of areas. Don't go too mad. And take your time. And there we are with the skin now done. We're going to move on to our next area, which is the red detail. So this is areas like the corset, the robes, and the blood in the goblet. Now we'll start by using corn red as a base coat. We'll move on to flesh terrors red after that. Keep it into the recesses, pretty much like a shade. Then we'll do any tying up we need to using corn red. Then we'll be using Wild Rider Red as our first highlight and then finish off with Bestigor Flesh, mainly on the robes. But first of all, let's start with that corn red. So I'm going to keep to my small layer brush here. Just get a couple of dollops of corn red, a little bit of water so it's not too thick and goopy. Mix it in together. And then obviously, as always important, make sure we have a nice point to our brush. Just add a little bit more water to that, just make it flow better. That's better. And get a nice point. And then we're going to start by picking out those red areas. So like I said, you've got the goblet here, so I'll probably pick that out, but you've got the corset and the robes. Take your time. Now, if you do find you do splodge maybe on the skin, you probably have to go back, do some tying up with Korax White, and then reapplying your Gulliman flesh. Just take your time. There we are with the corn red now base coated. We're going to use Flesh Terror's red. We're going to start running this into the recesses. Don't worry if you get on some of the raised areas because we'll be tying up in a moment or two anyway. Just take your time. It's what you're right around all those areas. There we are with the flesh terrors red now dry. What we're going to do now is pick out those raised areas just by tidying back up with corn red. So what we're aiming to do here is pick out some of those highlights, if you like, leaving all that flesh terrors red in the recesses. With the corn red now tidied, what we're going to do now is start with our first highlight, which is Wild Rider Red. So when we do this, we're just going to be picking out some of those folds on the cloth, starting at the top and just getting a little bit thinner as we go down. Try and keep as neat as you can. If you do find they get a bit wibbly wobbly or splodge, just use your corn red just to tidy back up. There we are with the Wild Rider red now done. We're going to finish off the red by using Bestigor flesh. I'm mainly going to keep it on the robes, but if you need to or feel like you want to, you can add a little bit to some of the extremities on the corset as well. No need to go mad, it's just a little bit here and there, just where the robes are catching the light. There we are with that red now highlighted. We're going to move on to our next detail, which is black. So this is going to be the leather boot and also the shaft of a spear as well. We're going to start by using Corvus Black. So what I'm going to do is just get a little bit of that in my palette, just dollop a couple of bits like so. And with base paints, it's always worth adding a little bit of water so it's not too thick and goopy. I'll just add a tiny, tiny bit more water, just so it flows a bit better. That's better. Doesn't feel as harsh on the brush when you start moving it around. So all I'm going to do now is just get a nice point to the brush, like so, by twisting it. Then we're ready to start. So I think I'll start on the boots first. So you've got some armor plates at the front. It's just the actual underneath part, which is the leather. So just take your time, work your way around. If you're not sure, just check the box art as well. There we are with the Corvus Black now base coated. We're going to move on to applying the rest of the colors to that black area. So we're going to start with Norn Oil. This is just going to swamp into those recesses to add some definition to that Corvus Black. After that, once that's dry, we're going to use Dawnstone as our first highlight and follow that with a fine highlight just here and there of Administratum Grey. But first of all, let's start with the Norn Oil. So I'm just going to get a couple of dollops. Wow, that's, in fact, that's just enough. So all I want to do here is I don't want to overload the brush too much. I still want to get a nice point. So just move that around a bit, remove some of that excess. And then we're ready to start applying that. So all I'm going to do is just start applying that over the Corvus Black. You'll notice as it dries, it will just concentrate more around those recesses and into natural depth. With the shade now dry, what we're going to do is start doing a highlight of Dawnstone. So just take your time working around like some of those fine edges. I'm just going to start on the front of the feet like so, just doing a nice little line. If you do splodge, just get some Corvus Black and just tidy back up with a little bit of Norn Oil after. There we are with the Dawnstone done. What we're going to do now is just finish off with just a little dot here and there of Administratum Grey. This is not really a necessary thing if you don't want to go this far. It's just great for characters, just add a little bit more depth to them and stand out a bit more. So all you're doing is looking for little blink points here and there, tips of things and very fine edges. There we are with the black now done. We're going to move on to the next area, which is silver. Now for this, we're going to start with a base coat of Einhand steel. Then we're going to shade over using Norn Oil just to add some depth to the steel. After that, we're going to use Achillean green to give it that nice bluey tinge that you see on the packaging and the heavy metal painted models. Then we'll finish off with an edge highlight of Stormhost silver. But first of all, let's start with that base coat. So I'm just going to apply a little bit to the palette. Touch of water as well. Now, sometimes with metallics, you might need to thin them a bit more because they can be quite thick and goopy. That's good because it means they cover really well. So I'm just going to get a nice point to the brush and then we're going to start picking out those silver details. Again, if you're not sure, you've got things like the blade, the little greaves here, and there's like little areas just on the front, like this front plate. So just take your time, work your way around, and if you're not sure, check the box. Now that our iron hand steel is dry, we're going to start going over with Norn Oil. So most of this will just sink into those recesses, just add a bit of depth. So just work across all those silver areas, like so. With the Norn Oil dry, what we're going to do now is use Achillean green. I've thinned this down, one part contrast medium and one part Achillean green. All I'm doing is just concentrating again into those deeper recesses to give it a nice bit of a blue tone. Now don't worry if you splodge here and there, you can always tidy back up when we do the highlighting stage. So what I'm going to do is just rub that in. I'm not going to do it on the blade of the weapon though. All the other silver areas are going to get it apart from the blade of the weapon. With the Achillean green now dry, what we're going to do now is finish off with some highlights of Stormhost silver. So I'm just going to start on the blade first, just using the edge of the brush like so. Just working my way around that nice bladed spear. Just keep doing that. Do the other side as well. There's a few things obviously on the other areas to pick out, like the rivets and stuff. Just take your time. If you do make a mistake, you can always just tidy back up with those other colours. There we are with the silver now done. What we're going to do now is move on to painting the gold details. Now for this, we're going to start with Retributor Armor. After that, we're going to use Cryptek Armor Shade Gloss. And then we're going to finish off with a highlight of Stormhost Silver again. First of all, let's start with the Retributor Armor. So just a couple of dollops on the palette. Nice little touch of water as well. And then we'll get a nice point because we've got some fine detail to do here. So you've got a few areas to pick. You've got the crown, just this little bit here on the actual blade, some detail around the actual goblet. And there's a lot of little bits of trim around the actual armor joints and stuff. So we'll start on the crown and just work our way down. With the gold base coated, we're now going to use Cryptek Armor Shade Gloss, and we're just going to apply this over all those gold details. Just trying to concentrate more of it into the deeper recesses, just so it adds some nice definition. There we are, with the Cryptek Armor Shade Gloss now dry, we're just going to start highlighting using Stormhost Silver. Just take your time, you don't have to go too mad, just picking out some of those raised areas, so that where the light will be catching. There we are, with the gold now done, we're going to move on to the next stage now, which is to paint the pale blue hair. Now, before you start doing this, it's worth just checking over the hair to make sure there's no splodges on it and just tidy back up with Corax White. So the first colour we're going to use is Ethematic Blue. We are going to thin this down with Contrast Medium as well, so I'm going to do two parts Contrast Medium to one part Ethematic Blue. So I'm just going to grab a medium layer brush for this. So I'm going to get two dollops, Contrast Medium, like so, just spread that onto the actual palette. And then we're going to get one part Ethematic Blue. Just going to mix those two together, so it's a nice pale blue. Sometimes from the actual pot it can be quite neat, so we want it quite pale. So what I'm going to do then is just load the brush up, not too much, and then we're going to start running this into the hair. So this will just sit nicely in those deeper recesses, and then just dry a bit lighter on the top parts. Take your time, move your way all the way around the hair. There we are, with the Ethematic Blue now dry and sunk into those recesses. What we're going to do now is move on to highlighting that hair. Now most of it's going to be a dry brush, but in some places where it's a bit harder to reach, we'll just use a layer brush to pick out those details. So we're going to be using Corax White for this. So what I'm going to do is get my small dry brush. I'm just going to dollop some onto the actual brush like so. And then the idea of dry brushing is you rub as much off as you possibly can on some tissue. Crisscrossing circular motions like so. What it's doing is it's leaving trace elements actually on the bristles. So when you start coming to like rubbing it onto the actual hair like so, it's actually going to start picking out. Now, when you're doing any kind of dry brushing, you want to go against, obviously, the details. So if you go up and down like so, it's just going to sink into those recesses. So you just want to go opposite like that. And you obviously, first pass is not always going to pick it out straight away, so you have to do a couple of coats of dry brushing. So work your way around, slowly picking out those highlights. There we are, with the dry brush done, the hair is finished. At this point as well, it's worth just picking out that little bit of gold jewellery on the hair, because doing this beforehand, it's just going to get messy and covered in Corax White. So just follow the gold guide for doing that. So what we're going to do now is we're going to move on to painting the teal or turquoise details. So you've got a couple of skull details, one on the knee pad, one on a corset, and you've got a couple of jewels on the crown and the weapon as well. So for that, we're going to start by using Stegalon Scale Green, then we're going to layer up with Sotek Green to a highlight of Temple Guard Blue, and then finish off with a little bit of a highlight here and there of Barrowhof Blue. But first of all, let's start with Stegalon Scale Green. So I'm just going to get a little bit onto the palette, a little bit of water as well, not too much. And as always, get a nice point to your brush. And we're ready to start picking those details out. With that base coat applied, we're now going to use Sotek Green as a layer. So what we're aiming to do is just pick out those raised details, leaving Stegalon Scale Green in those deeper recesses. Take your time, work your way around. If you find you do splodge, just tidy back up with your base paints. With that layer done, we're now going to use Temple Guard Blue as a highlight. So what I'm going to do is just find some of those edges and start working my way around the actual little details like so. Like eye sockets and noses on these little skull details. On the actual little gems and jewels, you just want to do a little cross. So just work your way horizontal like so, and then vertical. Take your time, and if you do make any mistakes, you can just tidy back up with those previous layers. With that highlight done, we're just going to finish off with a little bit of Barrowhof Blue. So on the gems, I'm just going to do a little dot at the center of those gems like so. And then things like the skull details, just looking for some extremities like cheekbones on those little skulls around the nose and stuff. Not too much. There we are, with those turquoise details now done, we're going to move on to the next part, which is the facial details. Now we're going to start by using Barrowhof Blue again. We're going to thin this down and use this for eyeshadow. After that, we're going to go to Corvus Black. This is going to be for the actual eyebrows and the eyes themselves. Then we'll use Corax White to pick out the whites of the eyes, and then also go back to using Corvus Black to pick out the pupils. You can also use these two colours to do the mouth and the teeth as well. So first of all, let's start with Barrowhof Blue. So I'm just going to get a little bit onto the palette, not too much. And I have a paintbrush of water as well, so it's quite thin. Actually, I'll add a little bit more, because we don't want it too thick, because actually when we start applying this, those highlights on the actual eyes themselves, or the eyebrows, are going to come through. So all I'm going to do is just start round on the eyeshadow, just there, picking out with Barrowhof Blue. And as that dries, those highlights underneath will pop through as well. Don't worry if you get splodge on the eyes like I've just done there, because we'll be tidying that up in a minute or two. With the eyeshadow done, we're now going to move to Corvus Black to pick out the eyeballs and also the eyebrows. So I'm going to do, I've thinned this down ever so slightly just so it sinks into those recesses a bit more. Just work your way around, and then when you do the eyebrows themselves, start from the top and work your way down. Now when you do the other side, sometimes it actually is easy to turn the model upside down if you find it's hard to actually get through to doing it. And also just sink some of that Corvus Black into the mouth too. There we are with the black now picked out. I'm going to move to Corax White to pick out the eyeballs and the teeth. So I'm just going to start on one side. I'm just going to like, so you've got a nice little almond shape in there anyway, it's a detail. And this is thinned down again as well. So I'm just going to slowly just build on that little almond detail that's actually in the eyeball. Any tidying up you need to do, you can always do back with Corvus Black as well. And then just pick out those teeth. There we are, with the white of the eyes now picked out. If you really wanted to, you could just leave it at this point, but I'm just going to start picking out the pupils using Corvus Black. Now, again, I've thinned this down. Now, this is the key bit, is you just got to be very careful, take your time, hold your breath, and then just pick a little line on one side like so. So do a couple of ghost moves first before you actually go in. And then the trick is to make sure you keep it equal on the other side. There we are with those facial details now done. We're going to move on to painting the base. Now I'm going to start by using Xandri Dust. I'm just going to coat over all the base details with Xandri Dust. After that, I'm going to use Deathwild Forest for any vines or foliage I find on the base. Then I'm going to coat all over with Agrax Earthshade. Following that, I'm going to use Athonian Camera Shade and just keep this into the deeper recesses for a nice mossy feel. Then when that's dry, I'm going to use Carrack Stone as a highlight, or I'm going to dry brush this quite heavily as well. Then after that, I'm going to use Wraithbone and do a nice light dry brush to pick out those edges. But first of all, let's start with Xandri Dust. So as a base paint, I'm just going to apply a little bit to the palette. It's quite thick and goopy. Just add a little bit of water to it, and we're ready to start painting. For this, I'm using a medium layer brush, and then we're just going to start coating those details. Just take your time and try and avoid getting any paint on those feet. There we are with the Xandri Dust now base. We're going to move on to using Deathwild Forest to pick out any foliage or vines. So again, if you're not sure, just check the images just to make sure where those are. But you've got a lot of vines crawling up the side of this stonework here. Take your time and pick them out. There we are with the foliage picked out. We're now going to apply Agrax Earthshade all over the base. With the Agrax Earthshade now dry, we're going to use a Athonian Camera Shade. Mostly I'm going to keep this into those deeper recesses just to give a nice mossy kind of feel. But I'm also just going to apply it to some of the dirt sand areas like so. Take your time. Once it's dry, if you need, feel the need, add a second coat. And there we are with that shade now dry. What we're going to do now is highlight that stonework using a heavy dry brush of Carrack Stone. So like we showed earlier when we were doing the dry brush on the hair, just wipe as much off as you possibly can. With a heavy dry brush, you're just putting a little bit more pressure on as you're moving around these details. In some places, like where the schools are, you can always put a little bit more pressure so it just stands out a bit more. And finally, what we're going to do now is use Wraithbone just to do a very light dry brush over that stonework and also the skulls. It's almost like tickling it. You don't want to put too much pressure on at all. So just gently rub across like so. Once that's all done, all you need to do is just paint the rim of the base, and for this I'm going to use Corvus Black. There we are with the rim of the base now done. Morgwaeth is finished. So what we're going to do now is we're going to move on to Kira, the Melusai. Now she has a couple of details that are different from the rest of the set. So first she has a big snake body, so we're going to concentrate on the snake body. There's the underbelly as well, and the hair is a slightly different tone to that of Morgwaeth and the other witch elves. So first of all, we're going to start with that snake body. Now we're going to start by base coating it with corn red. After that, we're going to pick out any of the black scale details using Corvus Black. Any of the light cream details on the scales, we're going to pick out with Wraithbone. We're then going to shade all over using Agrax Earthshade and then finish off with a nice little dry brush of Carrack Stone. But first of all, let's start with that base coat. So I'm going to use my medium layer brush here again. Apply a little bit to the palette. Thin it down. Now, you might want to do a couple of coats of this because it might start to look a bit pinky with that white showing through. So what I'm going to do is just load that up and then get ready to start painting this snake body. So I'm going to do most of the snake body, including the underbelly, even though we're going to focus on that later. I'm just going to base coat all of these details. Take your time, and like I said, if you need to do a second coat, do that. There we are, with the corn red now base coated on the snake body, we're going to start picking out some of those black scales. So all you need to do, you can decide how you want to do this, so I'm just going to pick out one. On the box art, for every one black scale, they'll do three after of red. So just do that, follow the box art, it's entirely up to you how you want to pattern it. You see, I'm just doing one here and having three red scales and doing one again. And also, you've got the spine to do as well. There we are with the Corvus Black now applied to the scales. We're going to start applying Wraithbone to the white scales. Now, you've got three rows of scales here. So we're going to do the middle one. And it's only the middle one, like the box art. It's always going to be next to a black one. So I'm just going to work my way across like so. You might want to do a couple of thin coats of this, because obviously it is quite light across red. Just work your way down, making sure you keep it into that scale area. With those cream scales now picked out, what we're going to do now is wash over all this red, black and white, or cream, using Agrap's Earthshade. So I'm just going to apply it all over like so and wait for it to dry. One coat should be enough. Work your way all the way around the model. With that shade now dry, what we're going to do now is use Carrick Stone as a very soft dry brush just to pick out some of those edges of the scale. You don't want to put too much pressure on it, you're just gently ticking those scales. Just go back and forth, like so. There we are, with the scales done. What we're going to do now is move on to painting the underbelly. Now we're going to start with Blood Reaver Flesh as our base coat. Even though it's a layer, we're just going to do a couple of coats of that. After that, we're going to use Magos Purple. And I'm going to coat that all over those details, and we'll finish off with a highlight of Carrick Stone. But first of all, let's start with Blood Reaver Flesh. So I'm just going to apply a little bit to the palette, not too much, a little bit of water, like so. And then we're ready to start base coating that on the underbelly. So, like I said, it's going over red, so you might want to do a couple of thin coats. Just take your time. With the Blood Reaver Flesh now base coated, we're going to use Magos Purple. We're going to apply that all over the underbelly, like so. And as you'll see, it just starts to settle in those recesses and slightly change the tone of that dark flesh to more of a purpley pinky hue. That contrast paint now dry, what we're going to do now is highlight with Carrick Stone. Now, if you wanted to, you could always dry brush this, but I'm just going to edge highlight just on some of those segments just to make them stand out a bit more. I'm just going to move down the side like so. And you can always just tip it to the side and then just do those front segments a bit. Not all the way to the front, just about halfway in. There we are with the underbelly now done. The parts unique to Kira are completed. So what I'm going to do now is move on to painting the pale pink hair. This is also featured on the other two witch elves in the set. So we're going to start by thinning down Magos Purple. We'll be using contrast medium for this, and we'll use two parts to one part Magos Purple. And after that, we're going to do a dry brush of Corax White. Before you begin doing any of this, just make sure there's no splodges on the hair and you've tidied back up with Corax White. So first of all, let's start with mixing that Magos Purple. So I'm going to get a couple of dollops, contrast medium onto my palette, like so, and then just a paintbrush of Magos Purple. Mix it together, and all we're going to do then is apply that to the hair. Again, you want to make sure it pulls into those deeper recesses and give it some nice definition. With that contrast now dry, what we're going to do now is start doing our dry brush of Corax White. So what I'm going to be doing is going against the recesses, not with them, because obviously you want to keep it in the raised parts, not in the recesses. Just go back and forth, put a little bit of pressure here and there. You might want to do a second coat once you've done. Just work all the way down to the bottom of the hair. With Morgwaeth painted and based, her and the Blood-coven are ready to head off into the Beast Grave to bring pain and death to the enemies of Cain. And remember, by following this guide, you can easily paint all the other members of the warband as well. Now, there's a couple of things to remember when painting these models. Firstly, when using any edge highlighting, always try and keep your brush to a nice point and take your time. When doing any contrast or shades, try not to overload your brush as it can quickly run out of control. If you do find that happening, just use your brush to soak up any excess. And finally, when using metallics as well, it's always worth changing your water after, because you don't want any of those metallic flecks to contaminate your other paints. Well, I hope you've enjoyed this video. Hope you enjoy painting your own Blade-coven warband, and we'll see you again soon. Bye-bye.